from the shubuhat, from the shubuhat, from the doubts, from the doubts, meaning here the opposite of dalil, or adilla. So here, their adilla that Shaykh Salih Al-Fawzan Hafidhahullah is coming to refute with, this dalil he coming to refute with, is in regard to the shubuha that the quburiyun, meaning the grave worshippers, they are having in regard to what is called their making or the placing between them and Allah as a wasita, as a wasita or wasa'it. Ash-shubhatu rabi'a wa hiya shubhatu, and this is that doubt that is very yani widespread indahum with them, which is that anna Umar radiyallahu anhu wa arda tawassala bil Abbas, that Umar radiyallahu anhu, he use Abbas radiyallahu anhu fil istisqa'i, in regard to their asking for rain, when the people were faced with drought, famine, wastasqu, and they were asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for rain. Fa inna Umar, indeed Umar, talaba min al-Abbasi, Umar sought from Abbas, عم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, who was the uncle of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, أن يدعو الله لهم بالغيث, to ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى for them, that Allah جل وعلا send the rain down. فقال عمر رضي الله عنه, say, اللهم, O Allah, إنا كنا نتوصل إليك بنبيك, O Allah, we used to ask you by way of our Prophet. We used to seek nearness with you by asking our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And wa inna natawassalu ilayka. He say that we used to ask Allah subhanahu, we ask the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to ask you to, for you to send the rain down. Wa inna natawassalu ilayka bi ammi nabiyyina fa asqina, O Allah, we are beseeching on you, we are asking you by way of the uncle of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Allah, send the rain down. Qum ya Abbas, and Umar ibn al-Khattab, he say, O Abbas, stand up, fad'u, and call on Allah. فقام العباس, and Abbas, he stood up, فدعا لهم, and he supplicated for them, فاستجاب الله لهم, and Allah, the Lord of the Alameen, accepted their dua. So here, قالوا شيخ صالح فوضان, he say, they say, meaning the قبوريون, they say that توسل عمر بالعباس, Umar, he sought nearness, right, with Allah by way of Abbas. And is they say that dalilun ala anna ittikhadh al-wasa'it jaiz, that this is a proof that for them, right, this is a proof that taking a intermediary between them and Allah to be something that is permissible. فَنَقُولُ لَهُمْ, we say to them, Subhanallah. فَنَقُولُ لَهُمْ, we say to them, سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ, مَا مَعْنَى سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ, what is the meaning of سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ, Murad? Right, when you translate it in English, yeah? When you say سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ, Ibrahim, what is the meaning of سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ? May Allah glory, may Allah give you good in this life and the hereafter, and make you a righteous imam of the sunnah. Hamilu rayatu tawheed. Ameen. The banner holder of Salafiyya in your people. Ameen. Alhamdulillah. It's important to make dua for our youth. Naam Abdullah. Ahsanta, that Allah is free from any imperfection. Ahsanta. So he mentioned Subhanallah. Inna Umara. Shasal for then he says Subhanallah. He say Umar radiyallahu anhu tawassala bi du'a al-Abbas. Look, Umar, he sought nearness with Allah by way of the du'a of Abbas. Walam yatawassal bi dhati al-Abbas. He did not seek nearness with Allah by way of the person of Abbas. Aw bi jahihi or his status. Wa innama tawassala bi du'aihi. He only sought nearness with Allah by way of the dua of Al-Abbas. Look what he say. Faqala, Umar say, Qum fadu'u. Stand up and ask Allah. Shuf. He did not ask Allah by way of the person of Abbas or his status, but rather by the dua of Abbas. By the dua of Abbas. Right? By the dua of Abbas. Because he say, Qum Fadu'u, stand up and arise and supplicate. Wa talaba ad-du'a min as-salihin amrun mashru'. And seeking du'a from a righteous person, it is something that is legislated. Sheikh al-Albani rahimahullah, he has a book that is called At-Tawassul. Short book. You know, you see the book before? At-Tawassul. Yes, I have a copy. It's a very good book, alhamdulillah. He mentioned that the means of Tawassul, it is of two types. The means of Tawassul, it is of two types. No, you're talking about the Anwa' Tawassul. But the asbab tawassul, the means of tawassul. You have the asbab that is kauni and the asbab that are shara'i. The asbab that are. Because what is at tawassul? It is what? No, the literal meaning of at tawassul is what? It is at tariq al mawsul ila Allah, right? So it is, but here you're talking about al-tariq al-mawsul ila al-matlub. The way that you are achieving, or the path that you're taking to achieve what is sought. That's what tawassul is, right? In the literal form of it. Yes, the way to achieve what is desired. The way to achieve what is desired. The way or the path or the means to achieve what is desired. Fahimtum? So here he mentioned that there are two asbab, there are two means of at-tawassul. Here, the mean that is kawni and the means that are shara'i. And he gave example in that book for the means of that are from the kawni. It's just like if a person is thirsty, right? He wanna do what? He wanna quench his thirst. He wanna quench his thirst. If a person is hungry, he wanna what? He wanna satisfy his hunger. So what is the way to satisfy your hunger? So that food is tawassul for you to what? To reach that which is satisfying your hunger. Just like if a person is what? Is thirsty. Drinking, barakallah, whether it is, let's say sometime a person does not like to drink, for instance, Pepsi. He loves Coca-Cola. He don't like Pepsi at all. But he's so thirsty that there is nothing to drink. But he wanna just satisfy quench his thirst. Right? So taking that bottle of Pepsi and drinking it, it is to only, barakallahu feekum, quench his thirst. So now, amma, the legislative means of tawassul, it is when the person want to reach nearness with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is by doing what? those actions that has been legislated by Allah. طيب, for instance, لماذا تصلي? Why do you pray, Muhammad? Because you want to reach rid Allah. Because you want to be free from the hellfire. So this is the path you taking to do what? To reach the rid Allah, the pleasure of Allah. Or this is the path you taking to free yourself from the al-azab or al-iqab. Shuf. So here you have these two asbab, the two means of at-tawassul. So therefore he mentioned hafidhahullah.
He said, turn around. Turn around. How old are you? How old are you? If I ask you a question, you don't have it, I'm going to do you like this. I didn't say what you do. I say, if I ask you a question, you don't have it, I'm going to put you up here.
Tayyip.
I'm going to make you taller, inshallah.
So when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so therefore seeking nearness, meaning taking tawassul, seeking or seeking the dua of a righteous one, it is something that is what? Huh? Permissible. And we mentioned last week or the week before the statement of Shaykh Uthaymeen. ماذا قلنا? We mentioned about here this detail of seeking dua from a righteous one. We mentioned the statement of Sheikh Salih Al-Uthaymeen. What did he say about that? About what are the conditions, you know, for you to ask Naam Hassan? Ahsanta, number one, he should be somebody that is righteous. Number two. Ahsanta al-maslaha yarji'a lil-mujtama'a. Right? That their benefit is for everybody. The benefit is for everybody. Number three. Ahsanta. Ahsanta. An yanwi. An yanwi that he, in his intention, is to benefit his brother to be in ibadah. To benefit your brother to be in ibadah. Because look, the one that is raising his hands, right, and calling on Allah, he is doing an act of worship that others are not doing. And making dua. Akhi, we barakallah fikum do what? We gain some reward from Allah subhanahu. لِأَنَّ الدُّعَىٰ إِشْ الْعِبَادَةِ As the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, الدُّعَىٰ هُوَ الْعِبَادَةِ Right? الدُّعَىٰ هُوَ الْعِبَادَةِ بِمَعْنَى أَعْظَمُ الْعِبَادَاتِ الدُّعَىٰ The greatest act of worship is ad-du'a, supplicating to Allah. So if a person, barakallahu fikum, comes to, alhamdulillah, individual and say, akhi, make du'a for our community, which is that, alhamdulillah, we're trying to open schools and, you know, do certain things that is beneficial for everybody. Now, it is incumbent for all of us to be actively involved in this and also, barakallahu fikum, to be making du'a. That Allah make this project, this, you know, things that we want to establish to be, alhamdulillah, very successful and to aid us all in regard to that matter. But it is not to be thinking that there is an individual that is out there. He is a person that his job is to make dua. He don't have no job, no business, right? He sit home and what? Collect and distribute dua, huh? Akhi, listen. Alhamdulillah, righteousness does not depend on the position that a person has. In Sahih Bukhari, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned about, he say that perhaps a person will be someone that if he is to be seeking for someone to vouch for, nobody will vouch for him. If he is to be seeking to get married, nobody going to offer them their daughter. But if he is to beseech on Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer it. This is of righteousness. It's not entitled, oh, you got to have an imam title, or ustaz title, or a muallim title, or mudir title. No, it's not about that. Right? You got to reach a certain level in the society to be a alim, to be a wali. Allah